Hi, happy Friday. Today, let's enjoy a simple Tang poetry Mountain Trip by Du Mu. Mountain Trip, 山行, created by Du Mu. Du Mu lived in late Tang Dynasty. He was good at creating poetries. People give him a name, 小李杜, Little Li Du. Here, Li represents Li Bai. Du represents Du Fu. Both Li Bai and Du Fu were excellent poets in Tang Dynasty. Now, let's read this poetry. 山行远上寒山石径斜白云深处有人家，停车坐爱枫林晚，霜叶红于二月花。山行，远上寒山石径斜，白云深处有人家，停车坐爱枫林晚，霜叶红于二月花。The first sentence, 远上寒山石径斜. It's a beautiful fall. We came to a mountain. We see a rocky path winding to the deeps of the mountain. The second sentence have two versions. One is 白云深处有人家. Another is 白云深处有人家. 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 One character different give us two different pictures. Personally, I like 白云深处有人家 more. So, in this video, I use 白云深处有人家 as the second sentence. So, this sentence gives us a picture that in the place where the white cloud appear, there are some villagers. The third sentence, 停车坐爱枫林晚, is already evening. We stop in a maple forest. Enjoy this beautiful fall. The last sentence, 霜叶红于二月花. 霜叶 is maple leaves after frost. In ancient time, people believed after frost, maple leaves were most red. 二月 is February. In here, it's better to be understood as the spring. So, the whole sentence means the red maple leaves are more red than flowers in spring. Thank you for watching this video. Please give me a thumb up and a sub. See you soon.